Hello guys, Neopet Times here, welcome to a new video, and today I'm gonna show you how you can make the iPhone the perfect phone for an old person. Okay, so technology and smartphones have become essential parts of our lives, to the point where today it is inconceivable to think of living without one. However, finding a phone for an old person can really be a challenge in 2024. Because what they want is usually something simple that allows you to make calls, maybe send messages, and that's pretty much it. And of course, with smartphones, they have way more functions, smaller buttons, many things buried into menus, so they can really be hard for old people to use them. Thankfully, Apple has thought on it and introduced a new function on iOS 17, which makes the iPhone the perfect phone for old people. It is called Assistive Access, and in this video I will show you how to set it up and how to use it. So without further ado, let's get to it. Okay, so now I will show you how to set up and use Assistive Access. So to set it up the first time, you will go to Settings, and then in Settings, scroll down to Accessibility. Then inside the Accessibility menu, you will have to scroll all the way down until you see Assistive Access. Then, if it's the first time you're using it, you will get this and be prompted to set up Assistive Access. And that's exactly what we're gonna do. You will get this screen, and you basically, it's iCloud, memory sharing, whatever. And then you will need to choose the appearance. There's two options, one of them is rows, and the other one is grid. I personally like grid better, so I will show you that one. Then you will need to select the apps that you want to appear in Assistive Access. So all of these that you see here are optimized for Assistive Access, and I will show you how that looks later. Then if I go to calls, you will see that I get this menu where I can choose who I want to receive calls from. In my case, I will say everyone, but you can say all contacts or selected contacts. At the bottom, we have a few other options, but we'll skip those for now. Next, we will add the camera, and in camera, you can choose what types of things you want to see. So I will select all of them just to show you. Messages, again, who can message me. Music, you can select a specific playlist, and in photos you can choose whether you want shared albums to be included or not. Then I will be adding Telegram just so you see one of the apps that is not optimized, and you will see that I'm getting all the permissions prompted right now. And that's it, so you can see that we have selected these apps. So we'll say continue, and then it tells you basically that if you triple click, you will be prompted to call emergency service should you need to. Then all the privacy information and the notifications. Then you will need to create a passcode, and that passcode will be used to exit Assistive Access. So if you are going to exit Assistive Access, you will first be prompted to enter that passcode. Then it tells you here that to exit the Assistive Access, you need to triple click the exit button, and that's it. Okay, so when we say start using Assistive Access, it will tell us to enter the passcode, and you can see that the iPhone goes to pitch black. And it says entering Assistive Access. This is why it's been dumbed down to the bare minimum. And this is Assistive Access. As you can see, this is the absolute bare minimum. It has the apps we selected, but we can include or leave out a few others. And for example, when I go to camera, you will see how it looks. I can say photo, and it will be the back camera. Or I can say video, and again, it will be the back camera, but for video. To go back, there's always this huge back button at the bottom, so you won't miss it. You will see, for example, that I got a new message, and that's how notifications appear. You don't get badges, there's of course no notification center, no control center, there's not even settings, there's nothing. So if we go to messages, you'll see new, and here you can see all my contacts. Then, for example, music, we have, since I added a playlist, I have all the songs here, but only those songs. And as you can see, yeah, all the optimized apps look very similar. But now we will open Telegram just to see how our non-optimized apps look. And as you can see, it kind of sucks a little bit because it looks exactly the same, which is of course not ideal. So if that old person that you're setting up Assistive Access to uses WhatsApp or whatever, it won't be as intuitive as this. But yeah, this is basically everything that there is to see with Assistive Access. If you want to exit it, you will triple click the side button, and you will see, well, there's settings here, we'll take a look in a moment. There's emergency, or there's exit Assistive Access. On the settings, we will be prompted to enter our passcode, and there's only a few settings. This one is very useful, text size, so we can make everything even bigger. There's airplane mode, dark mode, volume, yeah, of course, let's put volume in, and brightness, and shutdown. So as you can see, there's really not a whole lot. If I go back, you will see how huge everything looks now, because we, of course, made the text size bigger. But yeah, now let's actually exit Assistive Access, and you can see it takes a while Oh, I have tried it on my iPhone 13 Pro Max. This is an iPhone XR, so it actually does take shorter the more advanced the processor is. But yeah, you can see something very annoying, and it's that by setting the font size super huge in Assistive Access, it became super huge as well in the whole iPhone. So we're gonna change that the first thing. Okay, so we're back, and now we will go again in the Assistive Access menu. Since we have set it up, you can see that now we get this here. So this is to customize the Assistive Access once we have set it up for the first time. So some of these settings include, of course, managing the apps. You can add or remove some of them. You can change from rows to grid. You can add a wallpaper if you want to. You can, of course, allow the volume buttons to work or not. This can be useful because, of course, if it's an old person, they can set their phone on silent accidentally and they won't know how to deactivate it. Similarly to silent mode. And yeah, there's a few other options here like Siri, show the battery level and all of that. And in case you were wondering, this is what the list looks like for the menu layout. But yeah, this has been absolutely everything that there is to know with Assistive Access. Now let's go ahead and finish the video. Okay, so as you saw, this is Assistive Access. This is very simple to use and very simple as well to set up. The setup probably needs to be done by someone who's a bit more tech savvy than the old person, so maybe like some relative or something can help them. But once it's done, the usage is very, very, very simple. So yeah, this is great because now you can get one of your old iPhones and give it to your grandma, your grandpa, your mother or your father, and they can really get by using it. However, the bad news is that this is only available on devices running iOS 17 or later, meaning that it's only iPhone XR, XS, and older that can use it. So if you have an iPhone 6 laying around, you will not be able to do this. But yeah, as years go by and new iPhones get released, the iPhone XR will be what the iPhone 6 is today. Also, you can probably get your hands on a second-hand iPhone XR for around 100 or 150 euros or dollars. So it's not super, super, super expensive. But yeah, if you have any questions about this Assistive Access, please let me know down below in the comments and I will do my best to answer. And if you found this video helpful, please thumbs up so it can reach more people. Also, if you wanna see more tips and tricks for your iPhone and Apple devices, don't forget to subscribe, cause that's exactly what I post. And for shorter content, you can follow me on TikTok and Instagram. And for more thoughts, random thoughts and everything, you can follow me on Twitter. But yeah, thank you very much for watching and see you in the next one. Bye.